Science and Technology, Grade 6, Interacting with Computing Devices. In the previous lesson, we learned about how to edit data in Excel. Today, we shall learn about how to carry out simple operations in a spreadsheet like Excel. The operations are addition, subtraction, division, and multiplication. So we begin. In front of us, we have the open Excel sheet, and we have a table in that Excel sheet. Now, this is a table of vehicles that passed through a certain point on the road at different times. Now we want to determine the total number of vehicles that pass through that point at 9 o'clock. So we place our cursor there and then we write equal signs. We want to establish a formula for calculating the total number of vehicles at 9 o'clock. So start by writing an equal sign, and then after that, you write the word sum. You type the word sum. So you type it sum like that, and then you write opening brackets. Then you write the address of this cell for the cars, T3. Then you type the full colon like that. Then you write the address for this cell, which is W3. Then you write the closing brackets like that, and then you enter. When you click enter, the total is calculated. 61 vehicles at 9 o'clock. Now for us to be able to determine the total number of vehicles at 10, 11 and 12, we just click here, click on that total and click at the corner here where we have a cross. You click there and you hold and drag. So that will calculate the totals for the other hours. Now, that is when you are using a formula. But if you don't want to use a formula, you can use the ribbon here. The ribbon for computing various parameters. So you click here, put your cursor there, select that cell. You want to determine the number of vehicles at 9 o'clock. So after clicking there, you go to auto sum and choose sum, select sum like that. So all these cells are selected, but we want only the number of vehicles. So you click here and select the vehicles like that and press enter. So the value is there, the total is there calculated. And then you can do the same for the other times, the other periods. You just click at the corner there, hold and drag, so it computes the totals for the other hours. That's what we do. Now to find the total number of cars here, you just click here and do as we have done before. We can use the ribbon. Just click there. Click sum, then it is like that. You select for those hours like that and you press enter. So the sum is calculated, and then you can calculate the sum for the other vehicles. You just click at the corner there for that sum, and then you hold and drag like this. So the total vehicles are calculated for each category. Now to find the average, you just use the same procedure. the average number of cars during that day, you just click here. That's where your answer will be. Then you go to the ribbon, click at this arrow, auto sum, then you choose average. Click there. Then you want to calculate the average number of cars from 9 to 12. So you select that one like that and you enter. So the average number of cars is there. Now for the rest of the vehicles, you just click here at the corner there, hold and drag. So you see, you get the average for each category of vehicles. Now for subtraction, you want the answer to be here. You want to subtract 240 from 256. So put your cursor there and then you write a formula. You write, start with equal sign like that, write brackets, then you write the address of this cell, which is S. Then write S10, then you write minus, because you are subtracting, minus. The address for this one is T10. Write T10, closing brackets, then you enter. The answer appears there, 16. Now for division, you want to divide 256 by 32. So you put your cursor there where the answer will be. Write equal signs, opening brackets, then you write the address for this cell, which is S13. So you write S13 like that, then divide by, you put a slash, the slash is the symbol for division, put the slash, then write this one here, the address for this cell, which is T13, then you put brackets, closing bracket like that, then you enter. So that formula gives you 8. Now finally, how to multiply. Put your cursor there where the answer will be. You have to multiply 230 by 6. So you write equal to, equal sign, write the opening brackets, write the address for this cell, which is S16. S16 like that. Then multiplication sign, we use the star, that one there. Then we are multiplying by 6. This cell is T16. Then closing brackets like that. Then you do what? You enter. The answer appears as 1380. So that is how we carry out the simple operations in Excel. And maybe you want to save your data. So when you are done, you can go to that office button like that. Then you choose save or save as. So let us choose save as. When you do that, the following dialog will appear. Dialog box will appear. Give it time. Okay, so it opens. That's the dialog box for saving our data. So we give the name of our file that we are going to save. Give it as mathematical operations. Okay, where do you want to save it? Okay, that's the, you'll save it as Excel workbook. And where do you want to save it? We can say on the desktop or in D or in C like that. So I can click on desktop like that. Then I can say save. When I do that, I'm through. I've done my operations. Thank you so much.